The devil didn't create sex. The devil did not
have
create
nothing
sex.
To do with
he has
sex.
Nothing to do with it. It's just that
it's not the originator.
Permit me to say intercourse, because today, you know, even people get accolades like you look sexy.
Oh,
and
my.
they feel they just get as if there's butterflies in their stomach. But that's wrong. That's wrong. I think it's derogatory for somebody to tell you that you look sexy in our world today. It's derogatory.
Oh.
It's an insult.
Oh.
It's a big insult for
it's
somebody.
A big insult.
It's like saying you are a toy. You are a fornication toy.
Hey,
you are an adultery tool.
Wow.
When somebody refers to you as being sexy.
Wow.
You know, but today,
hey.
Unfortunately, our generation takes it as accolade, you know, as an accolade, so to say. But look
back
at this. The Bible makes it very clear on its prescription about sex.
Okay.
Now, whether we agree or not, the word of God does not change. Mm. It is you that have to change to become,
to
live according to the word of God.
Bible,
that's what the Bible says, we are transformed by the renewing of our mind.
Yes.
Now you say, well, that's not how they think. That's your village. That's not how I see. That's you. But the word of God does not change. It's a standard. It's a mode which we fall into and begin to align ourselves to live according to that, because it is the word of God that makes us successful.
Mm.
Whether people agree or not, promiscuity will always destroy prosperity.
Wow.
Promiscuity will always destroy prosperity. It doesn't matter how old you are. Now, why? We look at the word chastity. Mm. We are using sexuality because that is what is prevalent in our world today.
Mm.
You know, so we're looking at chastity is a very strong word. Now we want to see it from its simplest form permit me to use the word acute meaning. Now, because you see people who see the definition of chastity, where it normal dictionary says it is abstinence from adultery, from fornication, and what have you, to the point where it becomes a vow for priestly ordination. Where, you know, a nun says that she wouldn't have to sleep or have any intercourse or anything because she has made a vow to be a nun, or a reverend father, a Catholic reverend father, makes a chaste vow that, you know, now they have taken that as a, but we are looking at the aspect where it concerns having to live within the borders of the prescription of God's word, as a single person, you know that the marriage is honorable,
bed on the fire.
Because if you land on the bed of fornication, you live a life of affliction.
Hey.
If you land on the bed of fornication, you live a life of affliction.
Oh,
so
my.
When you decide to, well, it's not your business. Because when we talk about success, is something that destroys the filing cabinet of a person's mental ability.
Oh.
It just throws it like it's like bringing the sections of your mind and just putting everything up.
Oh,
that's
my.
What sex does. I don't know if you understand me, because look at this. It's a virus. It's a very strong virus that introduces it's vices it's in a life
system.
And makes a
outside
person
of the prescribed
that makes a person upside down. It's a virus when introduced into a person's system brings
God.
About vices that you can't imagine.
You
cannot calculate the calamity that immorality can bring into a person.
My
you can't
God.
Calculate it.
Oh,
you can't
God.
Say this is to the extent or what it can be. It's permit me to say it's an intercontinental ballistic mystic missile. It's something that you can't calculate. It's damage
Jesus.
On the life. Now
very
you see, we look at Dina, the daughter of the patriarch Jacob.
Yes.
Now this was a young girl who just went. She said she went to, you know, to look around. Maybe if she's living in modern day, she just went with some friends. They wanted to see what's happening in ShopRite, or wanted to see what's happening
around
in Spa,
the neighborhood.
You know, around the neighborhood, the Junction Mall or whatever, you know. And then before they get there, someone said, let's check this guy. We're supposed to pick him up too. And she ended up being raped. And the Bible says she was defiled.
Defiled.
Now, that word, defiled, is from the root word, French word, defiler. It is to take a flower and trample it with your fist smashing. Oh, it could never. There is no amount of rain that can make it recover. Oh. But you know, we're trying to just bring you the essence of that. That's why you see some people, unfortunately, they never recover from one wrong step. That was a sexual sin. From one wrong step, that was a sexual sin. So we are talking about something that is very heavy, and it's an everybody thing in our generation. Mm. But here in this definition, it says not just the action, but the thought, the thought, and that's the prescription of Jesus. Jesus said, when you look at a woman and lust after her in your heart, so it's not even the act; it is the heart. It is no longer the eyes. It's not, I didn't sleep with other. But God is in your heart. And as long as, for Bible says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Mm. That's why you see people, they appear in interviews, they can't coordinate because it just came out of immoral situation. You see people, they come to where they are supposed to bring out their best, they are turning out their worst. Because their life is upside down based on the calamitous lifestyle of immorality. That's why it's important. Marriages are being wrecked. People cannot control themselves. It is the beginning of a nymphomaniac spirit. You know, people don't understand that. Where somebody is so intercourse crazy that they can't, they would rather sleep with anything.
Oh.
Even if a goat is wearing trousers, they are okay. So you find out that is what is happening. It's not to call any man a goat, but I'm saying it's just to try to paint a picture of what is happening in our generation. And we know that it is something that God has prescription for.
Mm.
Are you hearing me? God has his prescription concerning it. Mm. When God says you should meet a woman without knowing a man, and the woman meets you without knowing, you don't have any expectation except what you are experiencing at that point. Mm. It is not what we see in our generation today. A man gets married to a woman, and the first time they meet, like 40 people are on that bed. The experience of the man in quantum, the experience of the woman in quantum, and then you see a misdemeanor. Everything is up because you are already expecting experiences that you didn't. It's a whole lot of issues complicating destinies, and people think it is just fun. Let me tell you, it is enlisting yourself to fight battles you were never trained to fight.